My name's Joshua Balderson, and this is the Hockey Nation. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Lou Jeffries Arena. This is Joshua, and it is time for some EOSHL action. We have the Gananoque Islanders facing off against the Smith Falls Rideau for the semifinal round here in the EOSHL playoffs. Now, this is the Western Conference final between the Smith Falls Rideaus and Gananoque. Smith Falls played last night in Deserano, and it was a pretty exciting game to watch. Definitely watch that if you can find it online. I know that there was some people there streaming that game. What happened was it was about 5-5 with a couple minutes left. There was a call that went against Smith Falls. Deserano scored, and then Smith Falls was able to tie it back up, send it in overtime, and Smith Falls won it in overtime, sending them here to the third round and the semifinals. So we'll see what happens here. They just got the Zamboni off the ice, getting the door closed up here, and we're going to be getting ready. So I'm going to fire you over. Oh, that's the main one, as you see. 2 minutes up there on the side. We have the bench getting over, and we'll slide you over here to the Gananoque room as that door's open. So they're going to be getting ready to come out here soon. We expect this to be a good game. Tweed got swept by the Gananoque Islanders. And now, Gananoque looking to do the same thing here to Smith Falls. Smith Falls is tired. I was told that they didn't get in until about midnight last night from Deserano, and then they had a quick turnaround to get down to here to Gananoque for this 4 p.m. game. Tom Dixon coming out with the rest of the coaching staff, so we expect to see the players coming out in a brief moment. You will not see Jake Komet in the lineup tonight. Jake Komet is with the Watertown Wolves right now, playing with them. He got his first career pro win last night with Watertown, and he's playing with them today, so he won't be here. We're going to have, as you see coming out there, number one, Leif Hertz, will be starting in net tonight for the Gananoque Islanders as the music and siren going here. We're about ready to get going. There they are. They haven't come out yet of the changes. And here comes the goalie. Got out by Dallas Slack. Put on quite a performance last night in Deserano. Look for another one here tonight.
Again, your 50-50 tickets are being sold up until the end of the second period, ladies and gentlemen. And on top of that, there's a jersey back for possible $600 last time. So, let's make the paper for tonight. Your starting lineup.
Excuse me. You guys can't stand there. You're blocking the camera. Yeah, he's just blocking the camera. I'm on live right now.
Number 40.
Jake Komet backing up will be Tim Tennant. But starting in net will be Leavers. We'll get to see here. He had a great showing last game when he played against the Tweed Oil Kings. See if he can do it again here tonight. that will do it, ladies and gentlemen, for the intros and the anthem. It's time to get going here. This series is tied at 0-0. It's game one for the 2023-2024 EOSHL semifinals here in Gananoque. There, number 44 for the Islanders. Eric Selleck, the captain, he's back. He got to play the last game at home against Swede. He didn't miss the first two games, but he's here for game one of this series to make sure he keeps the tone just where he wants it. These two teams met in quite a couple great games this season. One, where we got to see Alex Reese, number 7 from Gananoque, put a player into the bench. We hope for that kind of action here again tonight as we get ready for puck drop at the loo. Base off one back by Smith Falls, back onto Dallas Slack, who will stop that up and then slide it down in behind the net, battling to get that out as it comes out to center ice and will be chipped. Puck down into the Gananoque zone, onto the stick of Cobalt. Cobalt sends it behind net, trying to get it over to the far side as they're going to hold it. Centering opportunity, couldn't get that one to connect. It's come back to the point, looking to get that one shot off. In, but it goes over behind the net on the Gananoque stick. Stopped up behind the net as they wait to look for a way to get out of this zone early in this game. Gananoque's been off for a little bit, so they are looking to get back into things. But comes in Verbeek, shot just wide of the net. Comes over to the far side as Stevens will chip it in around. Couldn't get it back to Verbeek, goes in behind. We'll be chased down there by Duchesne, who gets a stick on it, giving a little bit of a hard time here for the Smith Falls Ritos, trying to get out of their zone. Still in on his stick of Selleck. Selleck sends it towards the net. Verbeek trying to get a piece of it, stopped up by Slack. And we'll get a whistle here at the 1 minute mark into the first period of play. Faceoff will be to the right of Dallas Slack as they come in, getting the draw here. One back to the point, sent in deep in around to the sideboards. This close side here as they're trying to get onto it. Blasco couldn't get to it, but comes to the point, chipped in by Latimer, and now it comes back out as they're going to chip it by Latimer, coming in the zone, looking, cross ice shot, and that one tipped, goes out of play. They're going to get another whistle. 1 minute and 17 seconds played into the first period here. Both teams are going to try to find a way to get a break. Smith Falls, a little bit tired here in Gananoque, but Gananoque not utilizing that yet here as their speed has. Smith Falls been in, and that was a great shot off of the faceoff onto Hertz, who puts it over the sideboards, and then it'll just get chipped into the zone by Costello and in deep. Gananoque centers that pass out as they're going to drive it in. In comes Higgs, sends it across, can't get it to connect. Shot in, save made by Slack, and that will stop the play. Face off again to the right of Slack, deep in the Smith Falls zone, one back. In behind their net as they will skate around, chip it up to the sideboards. Couldn't connect that one with Watzak as it goes all the way down, and it will just go by the net as it went through the crease, but not for icing. Sent all the way back down, 18-15 here in the first period. And again, Gananoque not looking at this point to get on to Smith Falls. Smith Falls not looking like they're going to be exerting too much speed here. You got to think Gananoque should be getting onto this. Trying to capitalize, that puck comes back. Latimer chips it in. The side out front now, a shot! And a good save made. Rebound grabbed up as Blasco got the shot from the circle. Couldn't get it by Slack. Face off, one over the side boards. Quick onto it is Blasco as he gets pushed off against the boards. Has some support, gets sent back to Latimer. Latimer shot just wide of the net, tipped over as it'll be chased down the far boards. Trying to get onto that puck as it does come out now onto the stick. Here comes the Rito shot in. Shot, save made by Hertz. Rebound, they try to chip it again. Couldn't stop that one. Hertz made another good save. Both goalies looking to shut the door here early in this game. will come in for Gann to go across from Pilon for this faceoff. Faceoff won by Pilon. Gets to the sideboards, they dump it right back in behind the net, chased down by Reese as he's going to get to the puck. Tried to poke it up to Smith, and that gets stuck up in some feet, but Reese able to turn it back to the sideboards. Salter with the puck, centering opportunity, cut off by Gannockways. Now they're going to come out the other way. Chipped in by Smith, in behind the net, as Slack will stop that up and try to wrap it around the boards. Comes to the side, hit. Reese popped out. Couldn't get that onto the stick of Salter, and then they chip it back in the zone. Now trying to come out was Costello, still with the puck, sends it over to the far side. They rip it in, but it only goes to the sideboards, onto the stick of Wiley, who chips it around out of the reach of Reese as it comes out of this sideboard. Now here comes Smith, who sends it far side. Drop pass, looking for a shot. Toe drag pull shot, and they got in, but off over to the corner. As Slack had to deal with the Gannockway players bearing in on his net. Puck just got out of the reach of Cobble. And now Gannockway is able to pick it back up. Verbeek sends it across. Intercepted. Is now an opportunity for Cobble. Spencer Cobble turns back over to the board. Sends it back to the point. Keeley tries to get a shot, but hits a body. Broken up quickly by Gannockway. Is now here comes Selick. Chips it up forward. He's going to drive in towards the net. Puck bouncing in behind the net. As Stevens can't get that one to settle down over to the far corner. Verbeek pinches, can't get to it, and they chip it back by where Stevens was, and they send it around to the far side. Gannockway had a little pinch, couldn't get onto it as it comes out, and onto the stick of Graham Brown, who's going to turn back and wait for some support. Fires it over to the far boards by the Gannockway bench as they cut through the neutral zone. Selick couldn't keep a handle on it, but it got picked up by Brown and chipped in. Selick continuing to pressure, but it's chipped out of the zone, and now an opportunity. But it got grabbed up before Spencer Cobble could get it by Duchesne. Now turned back the other way. Here comes Verbeek. Tries to make a move. Stops up. Dodges a hit there and sends it back to the point as Brown will chip it out. But it hits Selick. And Brown will have to pick that one back up, sending it in as he'll get stopped up by Slack behind his net and left. Here comes Smith Falls with some speed coming out. Spargu trying to get that one in. Comes back to the point. Shot. Wide of the net, comes over this close side as it's picked up by Gannockway. Blasco sends it over to Balakowski, far side shot, and that one just over the net as Slack was trying to grab that one with his glove. Sent out of the zone now, coming in, Spargu shot, and a save made by Hertz, rebound, grabbed up by Gannockway. Spargu was the top star in last night's Game 5 elimination game for Smith Falls in the victory. Keep an eye on him. Latimer has that puck, stopped up his blue line, sends it up, trying to feed Higgs, couldn't get that as it be grabbed up by Northgrave. Sent out of the zone, up to McKinney, who chips it forward, onside, still good, now chipped over here to Palakowski, who's going to come in, not alone. Palakowski sends it in deep as it'll be chased down by Higgs. Higgs chips it behind the net, chased down by Brown as he goes to get there, has some support with the D, Wiley in there helping him. As Brown and Wiley chopping at that puck, trying to get into the slot, and Higgs will just chip it. They'll go in deep to the corner, now turn back the other way. Here comes Smith Falls. We've got down 4.5 minutes here in this first period. No score. As it comes down, be grabbed up by Reese behind his net. Sends it over far side, misses, as they'll go down to the D for Smith Falls. And they'll look to turn back the other way. Turned in by Wainman. Has to get stopped up behind the net. By Slack, good move made there to chip that one by. And now here comes the Ritos in, looking for a drive, sent across, chipped by the D and gets out of the zone. As Keeley will have to backpedal, sending it over to Herbert, who sends it into the far corner, and it'll be chased down by Reese and Wiley. Reese gets to it first, rips it on the boards, gets stopped by Mitchell Keeley and sent right back in. Turned back out, all the way down. Stopped up by Tremblay in his zone. Sends it over to Keeley. Keeley has some time. Chips it up. And then sent in by Pilon as Hertz will stop that one up. Sends it over to the sideboard. Smith kicks it. And now it's grabbed up by Smith Falls. But it's some good play there. Gets it off. And now here's an opportunity for Gannockway coming in. 2-on-1. Centering opportunity. And they almost were able to get through it. But the D had a great job blocking up that stick for Gannockway as Hertz will play that off to Duchesne. Gannockway had his first opportunity here, a really good opportunity, almost getting one by. Over to the far side, Duchesne chips it back to the blue. Smith Falls will grab that one up, trip back. Sent in by Spencer Cobalt, now grabbed up looking to get in. Takes a little bump behind the net. Centering opportunity. Very dangerous. Couldn't connect with that one, though, to make it settle in on net as it went over to the corner. Shot coming from the side. Good save made by Hertz to hold that one up here. Across from Cobalt. Verbeek wins it back. Now he picked up by Duchesne, who takes it behind his net. Looking, sends it back behind the net to the D partner. He's going to send it up to Stevens. Stevens tries to chip it by. Pilon first couldn't get by, then does get it. Now here comes Gianacque with some speed coming in. Stopped up is Selick. Sends it back to the point to Duchesne, who turns, fires. Puck got tipped by, it looked like, Brett Costello. Slow it down just enough to allow Slack to get a hold of it, stopping the play. Stevens comes in across from Pilon for this faceoff here to the right of Slack in the Smith Falls zone. One back, Verbeek misses on that one, getting then is sent forward towards the net by Latimer. Couldn't get a connection on that as it just went beside the net. Turned back the other way, almost broken up by Stevens. A little bit of bump there onto Pilon. Verbeek trying to get that one to settle down. Pilon still sticking with it. Backhand passes it over to Cobble. Cobble shot, save made by Hertz. And then the puck cleared away, but not out of the zone as it's kept in by Brett Costello. He gets it in low. Couldn't get that connect with Patterson. As now Gianacque is coming out of their zone. For a little drive, comes Verbeek through center. Still drops a pass off. A shot came from Selick. Stopped up by Slack. As Verbeek left it with a nice drop pass, allowing Selick to send it onto the net. 11:48 remaining here in the first period of play. No score. Shots are showing 6-5 on the board. Gianacque not able to get anything to work here on a tired Smith Falls Rideau's team. We'll see, though, if that becomes a factor later on in the game. As Gianacque has had a little over a week to relax. Chipped up and out of play. Gonna have a whistle. Gonna come in across from Brock Higgs in the feet, but one to the side boards as they poke it through. A little bit of push there, trying to get that player off his feet, but the Rideaus control the puck. Sent up ice, chipped by McKinney. No icing, as onto it will be Dixon, who gets that puck up to the side boards, chips it up. We have a whistle as they believe that hit a glove on the fan bench, which will bring that puck back in to the left of Leif Hertz. Now you're coming in again across from Higgs. One back by Higgs to Duchesne. Duchesne shovels over to Brown. Brown gets that puck, sends it up ice, but it hit a stick and went down for icing. So a little bit of yelling coming from the Gianacque bench. That hit a stick on the way through, so should not have been icing. But the referee must have missed that stick tip. And he'll bring it all the way back down to Gianacque's zone. With 11:01 remaining here in the first. Face off in the feet. Blasco tried to pull it out, couldn't get to it, but then Brown comes in to grab it. Sends it back over to Blasco. Blasco turns, gets it up out of the zone as Gianacque will drive it in. Here comes Higgs. Higgs cutting across the center, sends it to the far side, but it hit the body. And turn back the other way. Oh, bad play there. Turned over by Costello to Higgs. Higgs got a shot off. Saved up by Slack. Seven to five are the shots so far in this game. 9 minutes and 25 seconds played down. Still no score between these two teams in the semifinal game one. And they're going to be kicking the Gianacque player out for the movement there. And that will kick out Coda and bring in Mangan. is going to battle, but one up by the Ritos as they're going to try to get by Brown. Brown chasing after that puck. Gives a little pinch to allow Duchesne to get in there and grab that puck up. Back to the blue line. Mangan battling. Can't get his stick on it, but it gets chipped in deep. Now we get grabbed up there by Wayman. Wayman turns it. Has to cut back. That was Smith had to cut back because he was pressured. Now over to the corner. Duchesne chips it up to the blue line. Blue line sent that pass up to Smith, but couldn't reach him as the Ritos quick to it. Dota gets on that puck, but a good whack with the hand gets that one out of the zone going in. Picked up by Duchesne, so no hand pass. Now turned over to Smith. Smith couldn't get a handle as it bounces, but a good play there by the D. He gets that one broken up. Chipped in the zone. As they have a second, it's Gianacque's changing, which will allow the Ritos a chance to get out. Sent it in. In behind the net, picked up by Wiley. Wiley carrying it into the corner, centers it up. Now a drive here for Gianacque as it come in. Verbeek, fake shot, dropped to Selick and couldn't get the stick off. Selick, rebound shot, and a save made by Slack as that one got kept in the zone by Reese. Now another shot from the slot by Stevens, almost. Just couldn't get that one down low enough to ring that top bar. Now sent out of the zone to Wiley as the Ritos are changing. Selick holding that puck, makes a little move, dealing with Spencer Cobalt, sends it in, he'll chase it down as Costello gets there first. Costello has to dodge a hit that was incoming and was able to turn and get it back out, but grabbed up quickly by Jack Wiley as he's going to get out of the zone. Turned over, Selick almost got Stevens, elbow passes that one up, but couldn't get it to Verbeek, as that would have been a nice highlight pass for sure. All the way down for icing. As Hertz will stop that up. 8:38 remaining here in the first period of play. No score in this semifinal, game one. Devin Cobble coming in to the dot. Won by Higgs though. As the shot comes in, rebound put off to the corner by Slack and then chipped up to the blue line. Gets out of the zone. Coming over, but onto a quick first will be Chris Latimer, sent over to the far side. They chip it up as they're going to try to drive in the zone here. Coming in, beats the defender, coming looking for a drive to the slot, centers it, and that puck is bouncing as Blasco tries to get on it and send it over. Gets it to Higgs. Higgs turning and fire, and a save made by Slack as that one's going to get to the blue line and out of the zone. But Higgs able to collect it, send it over to the D. Now up to Latimer. Trying to chip that one in, couldn't get in. Turned over by the Ritos now. A drive back the other way. Here comes Cobalt. Cobalt sends it back to Dowell, but couldn't settle that one down as they send it out. Now an opportunity just onside. A little shove after that. This Gann was trying to make a spring play there. Couldn't get it to work, though. Here comes the Ritos. Shot in. Save made by Hertz. To get a whistle at 7:35 remaining here in the first period of play. This faceoff will be to the left of Leif Hertz in the Gianacque zone. There's a good play there for Gann. Gets possession off the draw, gets it up to Stevens. Stevens trying to get by, but couldn't get by the defender. Good support there. Allows Gianacque to keep the pressure going forward and into the Smith Falls zone. Smith Falls looking for a way to get out of their zone as they'll come to McKinney, who just chips it. Grabbed up quickly by Stevens over to his D. As they look to rip that puck up, trying to get Wayman. Wayman does get to it. Has some support as they're going to stick with it, chipping it in behind the net. They center it, trying to get it. Couldn't get that one to settle down. Back to the point. Shot! And that one tipped. They couldn't get through. Now driving out. Here comes Spargu. Keep an eye on him. He has speed and the goal scoring stick from the last game, but picked up by Coda as he stopped up. And now Gianacque holding that possession on the stick of Duchesne over to the far side. Chipped up ice as they're going to try to get it through. Coda makes a chip play. Can't get it. Kept in on the line as here comes an opportunity for Mangan. That puck got chipped off his stick as he held that line. Onto it quickly is Reese. Will cut in front of Hertz's net and then send it up ice. All the way down for icing. As they'll come back into the Gianacque zone. 13:37 played down here in the first. first period, no score. Coda to face off here. Boschke in net there, and what are they going to do? They're going to kick out Coda. In the feet. Scramble draw, one by Mangan, now gets it up to Smith. Smith carrying it in, chips it by. He's going to chase it down. It goes in behind the net, almost connected there with Slack, which would be detrimental to the way that Cerritos have been playing. Slack has been on fire. Shot coming from Wozniak, save made by Hertz. Now Eric Van Rink is the backup for Smith Ball. So if something was happening to Slack, he would be coming in. But right now, Smith Falls doesn't want to see anybody getting close to Slack here, as he already had quite a physical and long game last night in Deseronto. 6 minutes on the clock here in the first period. Puck one back. Gann tries to clear it out of the zone. Can't get it out as it's chipped in deep, chased down by Latimer as they'll get pushed off the puck by Hulbert, but has some support as they get that puck in the zone. Onto the stick of Salter. Couldn't get it as Gann gets the puck back. And now here's an opportunity, shot in, and a big save made by Slack, and his helmet came off. They're going to keep an eye on that. That was a direct shot to the head. Doesn't look like anyway he's coming out to see him, and he looks to be fine. He's got a little nod there with the music, so just getting the helmet fixed back up, as that was a solid shot. Had to do a little bit of a ringer for him. But as someone who plays net, getting hit in the head sometimes can fire you up. Verbeek's gonna face off here against Devin Cobble. Back to the point, Gann sends it right back in. As they're going to chase that one down, looking, but the puck gets poked off the stick to the corner. As it comes down here, and it looks like we got a hit there. Up high, on two. I believe that was Chris Latimer grabbed his head. He's on his way to the bench. We'll see if anything happens there, but that was a high hit that got him. And I might see something come of that here a little bit later in this series. Drive in, makes a move, broken up by the D, and a good play there by Brown as a secondary D-man to get in and grab that puck. He's going to chip it up. As a drive in comes Blasco over to the far side, couldn't connect with Higgs. Higgs turns and fires. That one's up and there to play. Latimer is on the bench with his helmet off. Looks to be in a little bit of discomfort. We're going to keep an eye on that to see if he comes back out. But he definitely took a high hit there up in the head, and is in discomfort from that. Face off one by Gann. Duchesne sends it in. Higgs gets to it, tries to center it, but gets pinched off by Slack. It comes back to the point. Brown looking, shot, hit a leg, and goes off over into the corner. Picked up by McKinney, chipped to the blue line, gets out. As they're going to chase it down, Palakowski onto it first, has a little bit of pressure. He'll send it over to the far side, giving the D a little bit of time to get that puck up. They chip it, and it goes into the Smith Falls zone, but quickly grabbed up by the D. They go D to D, and then they try to get up and out of the zone, but a bouncing puck grabbed by Gann Hockway. Now opportunity! Palakowski ran out of space as he got pushed off over into the corner. Puck in behind the net. They're going to chase that down. Duchesne down there has Higgs with him. Higgs looking, trying to get it centered out, gets it to the front. Shane couldn't get that one. Bouncing puck to it is Brown, who gets it on a pinch. Now he's in behind the net. Puck being held. Center opportunity. Tried to get back to Shane, but it hit a foot and bounced out as Gann has to get back onside. Brown's going to send it up ice, gets it to Palakowski. Palakowski far side. Blasco shot, sends it over, and a good save made by Slack. Looks like he's not 100% sure where it is. He just knows it's underneath him. to 6 are the shots in favor of Gann Hockway right now. But 0-0 is the score. Gann Hockway will send out some fresh legs here. Try to keep the pressure going down here in the Gann Hockway zone. Stevens comes in, face off against Boschke. One to the corner. But Gang Andre, quick shot, and we have a goal! That one just trickled by. And we have a goal from Stevens as that one slipped through the slack, caught the post, and puts Gananoque up 1-0 in the semifinal, game one on shot number 12. Gananoque now sitting where they want. Starting the series off with a lead. Stevens is going to grab that puck up and get it out of the zone. Stevens, Verbeek, and Reese. Points getters so far in this semifinal series. Coming in the zone, though, with some speed. Brecastello tries to center it across to Cobble, but couldn't get it settled down. Then centers it in front of the net as it doesn't connect. And it comes over. A good pinch play there made by Patterson. Gets it back. Shot coming from Cobble. Stopped up by Hertz. Gonna go up here against Coda in this faceoff. One, over to the far side, quick onto it, will be Manning, and gets it up to Smith. Smith coming in the zone, cutting across with a shot, but hit a leg, bouncing puck, and the rebound by Coda gets on, but a great save made by Slack. Puck over to the sideboards, close here, they try to chip it out of the zone, get up onto the stick of Bosco as he comes in, drops it at the blue line. And they're going to chip it in the zone to the D, but turn quick by Brown. Comes over this far side here where Smith has it and sends it up the ice. Couldn't get that one to settle down, but Coda gets it, grips it, and rips it into the zone as in comes Smith looking for a hit. Duchesne gets it with a bit of a pinch coming in. Smith laid out in front of the net. No call coming. That was definitely interference. Higgs trying to get on that puck. They flip it over his head and all the way down into the Gananoque zone for icing with 1:49. You can see Higgs here talking to the officials. Not happy that he got taken, or that Smith got taken off his feet with no consequences. We'll see what happens again. This game could get a little rough. The referees don't make good calls. Puck bouncing at the blue line. Finally gets put out into the Gananoque zone, but grabbed up quickly by the D. Minute 30 remaining here in the first period of play. Gananoque up 1-0 in this semifinal game. Puck sent over here. Palakowski has it. Stops up. Looks for a pass. Sends it wide. Goes into the slot. Grabbed up by Duchesne, who centers that shot and couldn't get that one to settle down on Blasco's stick as he chipped it. Back on Blasco. Sends it out of this corner. They get it back in behind the net. Pinched off. Higgs trying to get that puck out. Can't, as it's on the stick of the Ritos, chipped up to Andrew McKinney, who's going to make a drive here. 1 minute remaining in the first period. Kenny drops it back. It's chipped up, but still grabbed up as they're going to keep driving it in here. Now grabbed up by Gananoque. Gananoque trying to get back. Barger trying to break up that play from Higgs. Able to get broken up, but Higgs grabbed it back up and sent it down as it goes in behind the net. Stevens gives pressure. Selleck on the ice now out there as well, giving pressure. With that puck coming out of the zone, here comes a drive from Keeley. Keeley shot in, easily handled by Hertz. And he'll stop that one up with 33.9 seconds remaining here in the first period of play. Pilon's gonna come in. Cross from Verbeek. Verbeek's able to win it back to the D, but it went through the D's leg. Couldn't get a handle on it. Centering opportunity. They couldn't get that one to go towards the net. It hit a body. Goes back to the corner. Now back to the point. Shot coming. Tip And that one saved by Hertz. Goes off over into the corner. Good play there at the blue line. Chipped out of the zone. As there's 18 seconds left, Smith Falls has to recollect. Sent that puck in on Hertz. He's going to leave it, hold it for as long as he can, but then covers it with 11.2 seconds remaining in this first period of play. Again, Ockway, looks like they are going to be going into the intermission with the lead. Smith Falls, though, going to have to figure out what they're going to do because they have only so much fuel in the tank. And right now, trailing Gan Ockway with only two periods left here to play. Good shot on Hertz, but save made from the point. Hit a body, cleared up to the blue line, sent all the way out. And that's going to be icing with 0.8 seconds remaining. They're going to pull slack, it looks like, to get the extra attacker on the ice as they're going to hope to get a face-off win and a quick shot off here. They only have five on the ice, though, as they didn't throw the extra attacker yet, but here they come, as we'll see what happens here. Higgs setting up in the faceoff dot against Nathan Slack. He's hoping for a win. That way they can't get a shot off here. As Smith Falls loading up towards the front of the net. Faceoff in the feet, and that's going to whistle and end it for the period. Sending Gan Ockway to the intermission. Up one.
12, 3 goals, 9 scores.
So, first period so far, great atmosphere, great game here. Gan Ockway is up by one goal. We have 12 shots for Gan Ockway, 9 shots for Smith Falls, and it has been pretty great so far. Both goalies playing great. Slack playing great. The one just got by, slipped by, and caught the far corner of the net, giving Gan Ockway the lead by Justin Stevens. We'll see what happens here in the second period of play. I'm going to give my boys a break. I'll see you guys back in the next intermission, or at the next period of play. ladies and gentlemen, welcome. We're back here as we're about to get ready for the second period of play. Gianacque, right now, has been able to get the one goal lead, but it is not a secure lead, let me tell you, in this game. Dallas Slack has been standing tall back there in his net. He's got to be tired. He's played a lot of hockey in the last 24 hours, and he looks to try to keep this one close and give them a chance. Gianacque, though, looking to come out. Like I said, they want this win. They want to get the lead here in this series. They want to go up 1-0, go into Smith Falls, win in Smith Falls, come back here next week and finish it off and get a little bit of break, because they have a feeling that the Smith Falls, or not Smith Falls, I do apologize, the South Stormont and the North Dundas series might be a quick one, as North Dundas was able to sweep their first series and now have the lead in the second series. So Gianacque doesn't want to be stuck playing too many games going up against North Dundas. They played them the last 2 years in a row in the finals. Haven't been able to get past them. So they're looking to do that this year. And the best way to do that for this team is to go in fresh and not tired. So we'll see what happens here. But as you can see, both teams coming onto the ice, getting ready to go for this second period of play. Face off one by the Ritos, getting it going here, starting off quick. In will be a drive by Kyle Dowell, just wide of the net. As it comes out of the zone, they have to send it back in. Hertz just leaves it at the side of his net for the D. As the Ritos have to tag up, they send it up out of the zone. Chipping it forward now. Gianacque trying to get in the zone. Chipped in around, back to the point, on to the stick of Brown, but a bouncing puck causes some issue. And now here they come back the other way. Dywall centers it across. Couldn't get that one to connect. As he gets chipped off to the corner now. Drive here for Gianacque up to Palakowski. Palakowski back over to Deshane, who sent it, but it hit a foot. Goes off to the side ball. Now Kip battling for that puck. They're going to send it out all the way down the far side. Chipped before Brown get to it, but he does it, able to grab it up, stop up, and then send it up ice, trying to spring Higgs. Higgs gets it chipped over to Palakowski, tries to back pass it, but fresh ice, stop that puck up quick. Puck out of the zone now, as here comes a drive through the line, but chipped in, and then it'll be sent again, as they just are playing back and forth here at the neutral zone, making it hard for me to chase down the puck. But now picked up by Gansnet, by Dixon. Dixon sends it up ice, trying to make a spring there for Verbeek. Verbeek trying to get through in the feet. Stevens chips through, can't get to it. And no one was there to grab that puck up as they send it back the other way. Now an opportunity for Smith Falls coming in. Across, and a good play there. Breaks up that puck. I believe that may have been Latimer, who got across there and used his leg to get sent back in to this close side here. They chip it back in the corner, quick onto it. Here's Patterson, tries to center it, misses back here at slack and goes all the way down. Be stopped up by Dallas as he plays it over to the far side, trying to keep it away from the Gianacque attackers. Here comes the other drive now the other way, looking across, couldn't make that pass to connect, and Gianacque picks it up quickly and then sends it over. Here comes a drive. Here comes Verbeek coming in, shot high, and Slack makes the save, but couldn't grab the rebound, bouncing, and then some shoving, but Slack gets a handle on it, getting a whistle here. See Salk standing right in there. They're gonna get some fresh legs here on the ice for Gianacque. And Smith Falls. Coda is going to set up here on this faceoff. Oregon-Aque wins it back. To the point, shot high and over the net, but glove down by Slack. Set up, same draw again here. One, back to the point, but broken up by Smith Falls. Here comes a drive. In comes Wozniak, cuts across, shot high, and a blocker save. Pushed up to the sideboards and then picked up by Gianacque. Now they're going to drive out, trying to get Coda. Coda just a step behind. Smith Falls able to clear it, sent into the zone. Gans tagging up, Slack will leave it behind his net. Onto it quick, will be Coda. Sent over to the corner. Be grabbed up here by Smith Falls, chipped over the sideboard. Graham Brown lays the head into this Smith Falls player, and a good play there by the D. And oh! It looks like Hertz got hit. We'll see if they're checking to make sure he's okay. He got taken out hard by Mason Mangan, who's coming back and lost footing. Both looked to be fine, but that was a heavy collision into the net here. And we'll keep an eye making sure Hertz looks fine. Again, he looks to be checking his stick, making sure the stick's in good condition. Cleaning off probably a little bit of snow, too, that would have got into that, as they had to reset the net with the pegs. Hertz seems to be no worse for wear, as they're going to get that net back on, set up to the right of Hertz, in the Gianacque zone. Pilon across from Higgs. Higgs tossed out for going too soon, which will allow Blasco to come in. One back by Lerito, sent in, couldn't get through. Now backhand, shoveled towards the net, goes off over to the corner. Then they send it over to the other side. Onto it quick as Pilon trying to send it in. Good save made by Hertz and then cleared out of the zone. Onto Higgs' stick. Higgs coming in, has Palakowski with him. Stops up, sends it down to Palakowski, but quick onto it. We're the Ritos to break that one up. Gianacque still trying to keep that in the zone. Does now an opportunity, but Higgs' pass broken up before it could get to Blasco. Blasco back behind the net to Higgs. Chip puck. Higgs still sticking with it. This is going to come back to the point. Duchesne gets pushed out. Palakowski makes a great move there to keep that from Corey Herbert. Palakowski made another good move to strip the puck, but couldn't gain control as it gets sent in deep. Quick onto it is Brown, sends over to Duchesne. Duchesne back to Brown. As he had Dowell coming into him, gets it up ice now. Here comes a drive for Brown. Kept in. Higgs gets onto it, chips it towards the net, can't get it to go. And a bouncing puck now onto the stick of Dowell coming in. 3-on-1 shot save made by Hertz to stop that one up. As he is doing a stellar job here tonight in net. Face off to the left of Hertz, deep in the Gianacque zone with 4:24 killed down in this second period. Gianacque leading 1-0 here in this game, one of the semifinals. And a good snag by Hertz off a Pilon shot. Got another whistle here. We're gonna kick out Verbeek. In comes Selick. Selick wins that one back to the corner. Chip to Stevens. Stevens battling with the puck there, trying to get it. Gets chipped out of the zone. Backhand pass to Selick, just out of the reach as they'll get sent over to the far side. Chip play. Good move there by Latimer to stop it, then chipped over to Verbeek. Shot in, hit the body of Morton, and then stopped up by Slack. And this is what we were expecting to come out. Some rough stuff here. Selick in the middle of it. I don't think anyone's going to get loose here to drop the mitts. Even though Selick is yanking on Dowell, but Dowell looks like he wants nothing to do with Selick here. A lot of talking. wanted nothing to do with that. He was trying to get away from Celik as fast as he could there and ran right over to the bench. We'll see if Celik goes after him again, but a lot of chirping coming from the Smith Falls bench, but nobody's stepping up yet. So Celik's going to sit for a little bit of time here in the penalty box. And we know that's just going to stir him up for a little bit later in this game. And as we can see right now, over there, Dixon hollering for the official. Official doesn't seem to be too concerned with Dixon. They seem to get a little afraid when they get yelled at here, as these USHL referees are bottom of the barrel. But, like I said, when the refs lose control, the game gets entertaining. So let's see what happens here, as we still have 35 minutes to go in regulation. Higgs wins that one, back behind his net, quick onto it is Duchesne, who sends it all the way down the ice. He stopped up there behind the net by Slack, left four, Tremblay.
Number 44, Eric Celik. 2 minutes for nothing.
So Celik will be in the box for 12 minutes here. So he'll be back with about about 3 minutes left here in the second period. So Smith Falls will have a little bit of time to avoid having to deal with Celik. But he will be back. And we know how when he comes back full energy. Drive here, comes out of the zone, sent down by Costello, stopped up by Hertz, couldn't get enough of it, but a good play there, chips that off the boards, and Gianacqua sends it right back out of the zone, killing down more time on this power play, as there's 1:20 remaining. Slack had to play it as Blasco had beat down all of the defenders for Smith Falls. Coming in, stopping up at the line, sending over to the far side, dropped to the blue line, looking for a shot. That one chipped wide of the net, over to the far side. They're close side here, picked up by Gasello, chip back in as they're going to dig for it. Duchesne trying to pull that out from Wozniak, couldn't get it as it comes back to the point. Now onto the stick, up Costello, looking, sends it over to Cobble, back to Costello, and the shot saved up by Hertz with 49 seconds remaining in this power play for the Ritos. So Spray, Andrew Spryger, who's going to come in to face off against Palakowski unless he gets tossed out. Oh, nobody gets tossed on this one. They let them play on. Played the line. Good play kept in the zone there by Nathan Slack as it gets chipped down deep. Looking, shot, good save made by Hertz, and he dives out on it to stop the play with 35 seconds remaining here on this penalty. For the first 2 minutes of the roughing to Celik. He still will have another 10 minutes remaining after that. But the penalty will be over shortly here. As Smith Falls looking to get one in before the end of this power play. Gianacqua doing a good job and a good shot in close on Hertz. Hertz had his pad in the right spot, didn't have to move, just took the shot off in the leg pad with some good positioning there. In comes Slack. He's going to face off here against Higgs on this face-off to the left of Hertz in the Gianacqua zone. Face-off one back to the point, but too hard as it goes out of the zone. And we picked up quickly by Smith Falls. Backpedaling into their zone, killing down valuable seconds on this penalty. As a little bit of a slip there in the puck. It's keeping them hemmed in. 10 seconds remaining before Gianacqua comes back to even strength. Into the zone, offside is gonna be the call with 2 seconds remaining on the power play. That will end it for Smith Falls. They won't have enough time to get in and get a shot on Hertz before the penalty will end. But will the short-handed player's situation here for the next 2 seconds still work in the favor for Smith Falls? We'll find out here in a moment as they're gonna set up for the faceoff just outside the Gianacqua zone. face off won by Smith Falls. And now here comes the penalized, the player covering for Selleck in the penalty box. And now we're back. Selleck will be back with 3:06 and a whistle. Dubique with the puck, holding it. Centers it over to Duchesne. Duchesne coming in, sends it down deep. Looking, gets it in front, and that puck sitting there. No one get a handle on it. It's put over into the corner as Verbeek was trying to get a stick on it. Now out comes the Doritos in over the blue line. Looking for the shot up high and easily handled by Hertz to stop up the play. Well, 42 remaining here in this second period of play. 1-0 still the score. Mangan's going to come in to the dot. He's another player not afraid to get into it. Oh, no, that may be Belasco. Hard to see the numbers on those gray jerseys from the arm. Little bump there by Mangan, trying to get in and start some stuff up. Wiley has to backpedal, trying to avoid the attack here from Salter. And we're going to have a call coming. Holding is the call. I think that might be going to Wiley. Not sure. Definitely were locked up together. Looked like both were engaging each other equally, but the official pulled one out. As you can see here, Duchesne trying to get an explanation to why one, not two, when both were locked up with each other. But EOSHL referees, it's a surprise every time they blow the whistle. Higgs comes in across from Dowell. Dowell's the one that got started a little bit of a scrum there with Selleck, but then ran to the bench right after as he didn't have nothing to do with Selleck. And right now he's probably feeling pretty safe out there with Selleck still having 9 minutes in the box. Ballerson's Hockey Nation, if you start get involved in starting stuff, you better finish it. That's what we say here. Another faceoff in deep, again to the left of Hertz. Quick onto it is Brown. Gets off of that one. But that puck stripped. Still sticking with it. That puck's going down. Blasco trying to get in to break up that puck. Couldn't get onto it now. Smith Falls trying to get out, but a misplay at the blue line. Gets that one broken up. But they still get to it. Here comes a shot from McGinney. Couldn't get that one through. Now another shot. Awkwardly, Hertz came across, but couldn't get to it. Seems to be fine, though. Back up in his net. As a body goes down in front of the net. No call, the refs are gonna let that one go through. Good save made there by Hertz off of the shot from Spargu from the point. Couldn't get that by Hertz as Hertz has been doing great this game so far. Taking 17 shots in the first two periods, keeping it here at zero. Slack has 12 saves on a 13 shots this game. Anyone's game still at this point. Brown onto that puck quick. Dealing with the attack. Dowell pushes him off, and that puck goes up and out of play. Tip says the official, so it's going to stay in the zone. Actually, I believe he's coming out of the zone. As they're saying, it was tipped off of the Doritos player. Face off in the feet. Duchesne tied up with Dowell, but out comes Verbeek. Verbeek got a hook on his arm, no call. And you can hear some complaining coming from the fans, I'm sure from the bench as well, as it's very frustrating when you get hooked after your team's on a penalty for a very, very weak call. Verbeek, though, gets to do the draw to the right of Slack, who's been doing a great job so far here in this game for Smith Falls, keeping them in it. He had a great game last night, and another great game tonight here so far. One by Smith Falls. Tried to get it by, but it got broken up. Now they're able to chip it through. as Caldwell tried to get it in the zone, but got it chipped off his stick. And now a little bit of pressure by Gann, causing some issues. As Hurd stopped that one up. Roger Brown lost his footing. He looks to be fine as he's getting up. Definitely not a good to see someone go into the boards like that. 10:45 remaining here in the second period. 22 seconds remaining on the penalty to Wiley. As Gann's been penalized twice this period. Which could be considered questionable. Now here comes Cota with the puck. Sends it up, gets it to Duchesne. Duchesne coming in, drops over to Higgs. Higgs cuts into the center slot. Shot just wide of the net. As the goalie didn't have an eye on that one as it went just up and over. As they're trying to get that puck now back up. Back to the point, shot coming in, a good shot. And we have a goal with the tip from Brock Higgs with the shot by Chris Latimer from the point. And it's a 2-0 game. The penalty was over, so it's back to even strength. Being able to keep the lead and add on to it despite having to deal with some questionable calls by these referees. ...10-11 on the board. Gann Aquwe has insurance now. See if they're going to be able to add on to that. Will Will Smith Falls finally be able to break Lee Hurts to get one in? Face off, one over and in running net over to Palakowski. Palakowski cutting in through, drops it to Blasco. Blasco drop pass, shot, and a good save by Slack. And then another shot just wide of the net. Came off the stick of Sean Dixon, now over to Higgs. Higgs has the puck on his stick by the game bench, sends it down in. But that puck hit a body and came out, got to Blasco's stick. Blasco back over to Higgs. Higgs over to Dixon. Dixon shot, and a good save made by Slack with the glove to shut the door. ...28 remaining here in the second period of play. 2-0 is the score, and Smith Falls, after playing a long game against Deserano, is now playing behind as they need to find extra energy that may be not there. We'll see what happens. Good save made there by Slack off the shot from the sideboards. Beek's going to come back in here against Pilon in the feet. Grabbed up by Smith Falls and chipped out of the zone, but they couldn't gain control. Wiley gets to it over to Reese. Sent up the ice, chip play, but onto it fast was Verbeek, who's going to spin it back, turn it to Wiley. Wiley bringing it back the other way now. Sends it up ice, trying to connect with Cota, but got chipped before he get there. Now he's going to chase it down behind the net, trying to get onto it, and some collisions there. No calls coming. The referee was there, didn't feel it was a penalty. Cota going for the hit. Cota, a little bit of spark of energy right now out there. And now a turnover shot and just over the net. Gann was trying to get that one in. Wiley keeps it in the zone. Cota's gonna chase it down. It gets spun back to this side. And Wiley will grab it up, send it over to the far side. Just couldn't connect with Verbeek. And then Morton engaging with Cota on the way to the bench. He's able to give him a couple free shots and get away with it. Roughly 5 minutes still remaining in the 10-minute minor to Eric Selick, who is in the box. Team has been doing what they can to give him enough free space when he comes out to do whatever he needs to, as they got a little bit of insurance now on the scoreboard. 16-17 are the shots. A little discussion with Dixon over at the bench with the official. Not sure what was going on there with that discussion, but face off in the body that went down of Pilon. They're able to get it out and chip it out of the zone all the way down, as that's going to go down for icing, sending it right back down into the Smith Falls zone with 8:14 remaining here in the second period of play. Face off, one into the slot, then backhand pass by Slack to Dallas Slack to get a whistle. And he'll come right back over to the same spot it was before. Higgs waiting in for his Spargu to come in. One by Higgs, back to the point. Chipped in deep, back around to Higgs. Higgs down low, has it looking for a centering opportunity, but it hits a leg, comes over to this close side here as a pinching Duchesne will get onto that puck. Tries to drive it out in front, backhand, and he's smacking away at it. He goes down, but the puck stays out. And we have 7:57 remaining here, 17-17 are the shots. 2-0 is the score. Face off, one back, onto the stick of Duchesne. Duchesne sends it, and Blasco tried to get a tip, just goes wide. Might have got a piece of it on Slack, but not enough to dial into the net. Comes over this close side, quick onto it. Higgs, but it gets taken out of the zone quickly by Dual, but then turned right back in offside as Malachowski was just over the line. Fresh legs out for Gan Aquay. Cobalt's gonna come in to face off against Wayman. And they're gonna kick out Cobalt. And in will come. Sorry, they're gonna kick out Devin Cobalt. And in will come Spencer. Spencer wins that one forward, but grabbed up quickly by Brown. Brown backhands it down, but it goes off over into the Gan Aquay bench and will be outside the zone in front of the Gan Aquay bench with 7:34 remaining. Around 4 minutes roughly remaining here. Oh, they're going to take it to center. 4 minutes roughly remaining here in the penalty to Selick for the 10-minute unsportsmanlike. A little bit of a body contact there as the puck gets sent in deep. Quick to it is Brown. He has to deal with Devin Cobalt. They're able to get up and out of the zone. Going down, not enough racing as it gets turned back to the neutral zone. As here comes Spencer Cobalt. Cuts across, looking, gets it into the zone. A good play there by Gianacqua's D. Breaks that one up. Puck bounced off the backboards. Quick onto it with Wayman. Not alone, has Smith in there. Smith tries to get it out to Wayman, can't get it as they're going to keep battling. Gets stopped up though before the blue line, stays in the zone as they're grabbed up by Smith as he's battling to get that one in. Now here comes Smith Falls out the other way, driving in, looking for an opportunity. Cobble coming in, shot, and that one's high over the net. Comes over, rebound, shot, and a good save made by Hertz. He'll stop it up with 6:26 remaining here in the second period of play. The face-off will be to the left of Leif Hertz here in the Gan Aquay zone. In comes Brock Busclair to face off against from Brock Higgs. The Battle of the Brocks. Higgs wins it back to the D. They put behind the net as they send it up the ice. Trying to get that one out. They do get it out onto the stick of Higgs. Up to Mangan. Mason Mangan does a pull move. Tries to get round. Centers it. But can't connect with anyone. He's going to cut down. Grab that puck back up. Keeps it in the zone. Makes the move to get by the D. Center it across. And that one just got broken up by the stick of the Ritos. Now coming down the other way. Higgs has it on his stick. He'll carry it in behind his net, trying to use it as some protection. Gets up to the blue line to Mangan. Mangan sends it across. Gets it up onto the stick of Brown. Colin Brown into the corner. Tries to center it. Can't get to center. Comes over where there's nobody. As Gianacqui will get to it. To grab that. Latimer backhands it in. That's Smith Falls. Will go a little DDD. Getting into the zone as they come on down here. Into the Gianacqui zone. Looking 4-on-3. Shot in. Grabbed up by Hertz for a quick whistle. Right now, Smith Falls are putting a lot of their shots up high onto Hertz, which is not working for them as Hertz's glove has stopped everything it's seen tonight. They might want to try to put some a little bit lower on Hertz, as right now he is all dialed in with that glove. In comes Nick Peel on the faceoff against Ryan Vermeek here at this faceoff. Vermeek wins it back. Gianacqui puts it behind their net as they're going to try to drive it up the sideboard, gets it up the ice. Here's Verbeek now with it coming into the zone. Shot high, and it was grabbed up by Slack, and he'll hold it. Might have been going over the net on that one. Face off one, and then whistled down. It again. Verbeek wins it back again. Shot from the point. Bouncing puck. Verbeek comes right to get it, but a diving across Slack gets that puck. And the pushing is going to continue here as Pilon was giving a little bit of a shove to Koda. But he might want to be careful because there's only about 2 minutes left on the penalty to Selick and a whistle before he'll be coming out and might be able to calm things down here a little bit. In comes Verbeek, face cost from Spargu. One in the feet, chipped up and out of the zone comes Smith Falls. Wall gets in, centers it in front of the net and a good save made there by Hertz. It looked to me like Andrew McKinney got taken down going beside the net. He's got some things to say to Wyatt Koda. But as we've seen so far, it doesn't look like Smith Falls is ready to stand up for all this chirping, so it'll just go as another little bit of a chirp fest. Until they drop the gloves, it don't matter. Sent up the ice, here comes Verbeek, sends over to the far side, driving in the zone, looking, centering across to Koda, but a bouncing puck, couldn't get on it, was able to keep that puck though, tries to center it, tips and goes off the side, boards back, behind the net, chipped out by Verbeek, couldn't get a handle of those, Koda. As it comes out of the zone, now here comes a drive, stopped up at the blue line. Offside is the call, 4:42 remaining in the second period of play. Coming in to face off against Higgs. Battle won by Gianacqui. Face or puck comes back over to Latimer. Latimer trying to get it but can't lose the puck. Now he's going to battle in behind the net with the Ritos player who's going to chop it back, getting it over to Cobalt. Cobalt now battling with it down low, trying to get it forward. Centered it, couldn't get it to stay in the zone as they're going to have to come out and tag back up. Northgrave sends it in, stopped up by Hertz, grabbed up by the D, who's going to send it up, but it hits the official's leg, and now stays in the zone. Gianacqui has to come back to try to grab that one out, sent in, saved up by Hertz, with 4:08 remaining. Cobble will come in again across from Higgs. One to the winger, the D is. Latimer goes into the corner, has Higgs there with him as they're trying to bring it through. Player goes down, no call coming. You hear Smith Falls bench not happy, felt there should have been a call there. Puck stays in the zone on the stick of Higgs. Higgs looking, toe drag shot, and that one hit a foot and then got put over to slot, grabbed up by the Ritos as they're going to come down in, cuts in and sends it in onto Hertz. Hertz just handles that one off of the blocker over to the side boards. Almost comes out of the zone. There's a battle there. Trying to get that puck out. He's going to go up in behind the net. Stopped up by Gann. As he's going to chip it up to the side boards. Now Palakowski has it. Sends it up forward onto Higgs' stick. Higgs' comes in the zone. Stops up. Centers it over to Palakowski, but couldn't connect. Puck chipped out of the zone. Now down into Gann's zone, but onto the defense stick. They're going to play it off of the glass. All the way down. As here they have turned now. At that time, Salek will be coming out. Any whistle now. Keep battling. Shot. Good save made by Hertz as they chip it up. Now here's an opportunity. Gann coming back with some speed. Here comes Wayman. Wayman coming through. Cuts over to the side. Stops up. Centers it. Couldn't get it to center through. And that grabbed up by the D. Brown. Just over the blue line. So we had to cycle back and get the team back inside. Wayman chips it in. Can't get it by the D of Smith Falls. And it's sent all the way out of the zone. Come down onto Hertz. He's going to play it over to Duchesne. Duchesne grabs it. Sends it up ice. Trying to do a drive here for Smith. Smith sends a pass across and a big shot just wide by Verbeek. Now here comes Smith Falls. McKinney coming in, looking backhand. Good save made by Hertz. And that puck, they're going to play for a whistle. And that's going to end Selleck's 10-minute minor. And he'll be back on the ice. Face off one over to Wiley. Wiley gets that puck, dodges a couple attackers, and now is going to carry it out of the zone. He's getting hooked and hacked on, doesn't get any call, gets pulled down in the Smith Falls zone, has to get back up and retreat. 2 minutes remaining here. On to Salek stick, but couldn't control that. As it bounces, hits Stevens' leg, and they're going to chip that one out and down into the zone. Onto the puck. Spider tries to center it. Couldn't connect with Dowell. Verbeek has that puck. Cutting in. Loses it in the slot. Salek's going to chase down. Trying to get a stick on it. Good play there by Hurst to direct it over to the far boards. Brown's going to chip it along the boards and gets it out. Now Salek gets that puck. Salek has it. He's going to drive towards the net and gets that puck poked off his stick just as he was getting towards the net. He'll go to the bench, and now here comes an opportunity as in comes Cobalt. Shot wide of the net. This is going to come all the way out of the zone, and now a chase for it. As onto it quick as Mason Mangan backhands it back to Stevens. Stevens now battling. Has Rabeek come in? Still on the stick as Stevens. As Rabeek comes in to peel that one out. Stops, makes a move, but it gets off his foot. Comes out of the zone as Brown's going to grab that up. 49 seconds remaining here. Shot in on slack. They'll get left as now out of the zone comes the Ritos. They turn it over. Now coming out the bench. Here comes an opportunity for again. But a good stick work by the Ritos. Breaks that one up. Mangan has it. Sends it over into the corner. Over to the far side point. Looking for a shot. And that one just wide net. Oh, sorry. Up and out of play. 26 seconds remaining here. They're saying out, Gann saying in. They're not going to win this argument with the referee. So now, a meeting of what is called the minds, whether you call that here or not, but a meeting of the minds. And it took four of them, but they finally got the call right. So the faceoff will be inside the zone. 26.2 seconds remaining here in this second period. They're going to kick Higgs out. Both players moved, but Higgs was the one that they want to pick on, so they get him out of the zone. Back to the point, shot coming, and a good save made by Slack. Rebound and another good save by Slack, but Gannockway still has the puck on their stick, trying to move it down low, pushed off the body. Blasco gets over to the far side. They try to center it. They do get it across, but Blasco can't get that one off. And it's cleared out of the zone. Quick onto it was Cobalt. But Brown getting it. 4 seconds remaining. They're going to try to get one last opportunity in the zone. Here comes his shot. And a save made by Hertz. Right at the whistle.
or the Reno's ahead. Your Islanders are ahead 2-0.
So what can we talk about in the second period of play? Again, Akwe has a 2-goal lead, which is putting them right where they want to be. There was a little bit of scuffle. Selick tried to fight with Kyle Dowell, but Dowell wanted nothing to do with it and skated as fast as he could to the bench. So he got to the bench and got off. Selick got a 2 and a 10, and now we'll see what happens because Selick's no longer in the box, and we'll see if the players are going to stand up for trying to start some rough stuff with him or if they're going to run away each time. We'll find out here. Right now, I'm sure Smith Falls doesn't want to get into a fight fest with Gianacque, as Gianacque does have a little bit more in that category that they should be able to win the fight situation. So we'll see what happens. But if they keep pushing, there might be a point sooner or later where a helmet gets ripped off and you got to stand up for what you're doing. We'll see what happens in this third period of play. But right now, Gianacque has a 2-0 lead. We'll be back. Thank you for watching. Hello, everybody. Welcome back. We're about to get going here to the third period. 21 shots to 24 up on the board. 2-0 is the score for Gananoque. More shots coming out of Smith Falls, but they're having a hard time beating Leif Hertz, who's been playing excellent play. They've been looking a lot at his glove, it seems, this game, and haven't been able to get by his glove. A couple blocker saves, but what they really need to be doing is, I think, getting him moving down low and shooting low on him. But right now, they've been shooting high, and it's that 2-0. We did have, like I said, a little bit of an issue in the second period between Kyle Dowell and Eric Salah. Salah wanted to go. Dowell didn't want to. Salah got himself 12 minutes for it. Salah goes back, and we'll see what happens in this third period. So let us jump you on over here as we get ready here for this third period of play. Left in regulation. Will it make it to overtime? Will it end in regulation? We'll find out. One team will be going up 1-0 in the series. Will it be Smith Falls? Will it be Gananoque? Right now, Gananoque has the lead. So we'll see what happens. Referee's coming to the ice now. It's time to get going for the third period of play. It's in the feet as Smith Falls is able to win it back to their D as they set it back. They are sitting down 2-0, needing to get themselves a couple goals here. Otherwise, they're going to find themselves down one game in this best of five series. Brown carrying the puck, sends it in. It's going to go in behind the net all the way out. But the D coming in, gets it with some speed, coming in, looking over to Blasco, tried to send it back, couldn't get it to settle down. Puck hit a body, goes off in behind the net, round to this close side. Is that puck in the feet, now comes out on Brown's stick, Brown driving in, coming along the line, cuts over, looking for a backhand pass, centers it, now an opportunity, oh, and a bouncing puck. Got chipped off of Blasco's stick. Otherwise, he would have had a great opportunity to shoot there. Puck into the zone. Bouncing, causing some issues. And now, it's grabbed up. Here comes Smith Falls. Shot in on Hertz. Save made. Comes over to the sideboard. Back onto the Rideau stick as they send it into the far corner. Dowell gets it. Gets hit by Dixon. As it comes over to this close side here. Blasco trying to get that puck out of the zone, can't, so the D sends it back over. Selick will get into that puck first as he's being pestered by the attackers. They're able to get out. Now here comes Verbeek, makes a move, stops up in the zone, cutting back. Puck chipped off his stick as they're going to try to bring it back the other way, but a good play there. Turns it back the other way, but it's going to be icing. Bring it back into the Gananoque zone. Face off here, won by Smith Falls. Back to the point, over here to Keeley. Keeley shot, and he scores! It's a 2-1 game as Smith Falls tries to start the comeback here in game one. Mitchell Keeley puts it by Hertz, breaking his shutout. faceoff here, won by Gananoque. Chipped into the Smith Falls zone, but they can't get it in deep as it gets turned back the other way quickly to Bram Brown. Brown tries to get over, can't. And a good blocker save made by Swimmington by Hertz. Puck over into the corner. As you can tell now, Smith Falls trying to make a game of it here. Shot from the point and a good save made by Hertz as that came off of the stick of Salter. So, with this early start here for the Ritos, Gananoque needs to settle things down and get back down to the other end. Otherwise, the Ritos can use this opportunity to try to tie this game up. Onto the stick of Stevens. Stevens carrying it in. Tries to pull it through the D, but a good move with the foot keeps that puck from getting by. And now turn back to the way. Here comes Smith Falls. In behind the net. Rubbed out on the play, and Brown comes out with the puck the other way. Chips it. Up, and now here comes Stevens. Stevens over to Verbeek. Verbeek back to Stevens. Hit his foot as they couldn't settle that one in on the stick. And now it's coming out the other way as here comes a shot and a goal as that one gets by Hertz. And just like that, Smith Falls ties it off. Justin Salter gets one by Hertz that was bobbling on his glove, and now we have a tie game. Smith Falls has 26 shots. Gananoque has 21. Now Higgs is going to come into the faceoff dot. There seems to be something going on. Well, it looks like they tried to switch a player and the ref said, not now, get back on. And now they're going to be back to going here. So 3 minutes in here to the second period of play, or third period of play, and we have a tie game. Gananoque needs to figure out what they're going to do here to get the lead back. Otherwise, Smith Falls is going to try to use momentum from their win yesterday to get another one here today. Here comes Palakowski, sends over to the far side, bouncing puck on Higgs. Higgs centers it in front of the net, and it goes up and out of play. Into the faceoff comes Cobalt, wins that one against Higgs. Out to the blue line. As here comes Cobalt coming in. Drop pass. Shot. Save made by Hertz. Rebound out to the slot. Picked up by Palakowski, who's going to come in the zone. Cuts through the slot on his own. Centers it. Couldn't get that one to Higgs. And now an opportunity goes on to the back of the net. As it looked to me like Glasgow was coming in. Got the backhand, but just couldn't get it to narrow down to the open part of the net. We have 16-11 here in the third period. Higgs is gonna come in to the faceoff. Levy's against Spargu right now, who's gonna get tossed out. In comes Dowell. One over to Tremblay, who sends it over to the far side. Smith Falls gonna exit the zone, but they only get to Gananoque's blue line as that puck gets turned back. Now, onto the pick, stick of Latimer as he chips it down the ice. The Ritos stop that up in their zone, play a little D&D, trying to keep that away. But now into the feet of the ref and almost Coda's stick. Coda now gets onto it, centers it. And that puck grabbed up in the slot by the Ritos, sent all the way down onto the net. And Dixon will grab that one off of the stick of Hertz. Sent back up to the blue line. Now Gananoque driving it out, gets it onto Smith's stick. Smith coming in, shot! And the blocker save, rebound comes out to the slot. Onto it quick is Coda, and they shot it. We have a goal! Gananoque takes scored by number 72, Cody Smith. With 15:22 remaining in the third, Gananoque restores the lead. Looking now to try to get the insurance marker back they once had. As this game cranking up here in the third. Coda Smith collided there. Hard at the blue line. Both seem to be fine, but definitely broke the ability to break into the zone.
And number 11, Mason Mangan.
Mangan's trying to hold that one in his feet. Coda pushing around. Yes, finally give a whistle. Stopping that play. So the faceoff will be right in front of the Gananoque bench. Won by Gananoque, back to the D. They go D to D, getting it onto Brown's stick. Brown chips it up, two. Colin Brown, but was unable to get that one to settle down. Now onto the stick of Brett Costello, who sends it over to the far side. Chipped up ice. There's a little bit of a bump there by Reese. Almost broke up that play, but they're keeping it in the zone now. Chipped over. Sorry, that was McCarty that did that little bump. Puck at the side of the net. Gan quick on it, chipped up to the glass, hit the body of Brown, bounced down, and then got chipped by the side of the net. Now McCarty onto it, gets it up and out of the zone. There's going to be a little bit of a race for it, but quick onto it is. Andrew McKenney gets it over to Salter, one of the goal scorers. They turn it back the other way. Palakowski gets that one off of the D, turns down and scores! To make it 4-2! And Verbeek came in the zone, stripped the puck from the defender, got by, made a quick move, and slipped it over top of Slack, giving that insurance marker back, and we're back to a two-goal lead here for Gananoque in the third, and now 13:50 remaining. How will Smith Falls respond? Face off one. Back to Leif Hertz, who's going to chip it over the sideboards. Latimer couldn't get there first, as it was just a step out of his reach. Now a shot saved by Hertz, as he had Patterson trying to get a tip on that right in front of the net. So they're going to save Verbeek with an assist to Duchesne. Not sure how Duchesne got in on that one, as it was on the stick of the Rideau's player and then stripped, but I never try to figure out what happens here with the officials. Puck now in the Smith Falls zone, wrapped around to the sideboards, trying to chip it up. Gets off of the foot and driven out of the zone as Cobalt tries to get going but can't. Selleck gets a hold of that puck and sends it over to the D. They get to chip it up. Verbeek chips it off his foot. Now a foot race. He's going to get there first. Driving to the net. Shot. Just couldn't connect there as it comes out the other side. As Selleck will get that back to the D. Turn it back. 13 minutes remaining here in this third period of play. Smith Falls needing to find something to get them back in this. Sent up ice. Chipped by, shot coming. Up and out of play. And I think that might have gone off of the, Dallas' slack stick, not Duchesne's, and that's why it will be inside the zone. Face off here. Higgs comes in across from Pilon in the feet. Pilon gets it, pulls it out, sends it to the sideboards, gets it through. We're able to get out of the zone now. Here comes a rush. Pilon coming in. Shot hard. Just wide of the net and chipped away by Brown to the point. Then sent in. Save made. Rebound kicks out. Now an opportunity for again for the stretch pass to Higgs. And a big save made by Slack. As it was just Higgs versus Slack, and Slack stood tall to stop that one. Sparger's gonna come in across from Higgs here. One back, Blasco gets it back to D. They chip it right back to it. Puck moving around well in Smith Falls zone by Gananoque, and a chip play gets that forward looking for a shot. Now to the side shot, and a good save made by Slack as he got that sliding across. Here comes Sparger, stops up, looking, sends it back to McKinney. McKinney shot, couldn't get that one to dial down, and Costello goes in. Chip play up and out of play as it hit the ceiling. Faceoff will be to the right of Leif Hertz in the Gananoque zone. Sparger is going to come into the faceoff dot. The faceoff against Wyatt Cota. One by Sparger. Back to the point. Shot wide of the net. As they try to get a center, they couldn't get a piece of it, and it gets chipped over the boards. Now out of the zone. As Brown chips it in. Under quick is Smith. Smith centers it. Slack trying to make a save. Puck bobble. They're cracking away at that puck, trying to get in the net, but can't get it by the wall that Slack had built with his leg. Cota comes into the faceoff to face off against Bosker. Oshar wins it back. Quick under it is Slack. Takes a little bit of a bump from Mangan. That puck gets out of the zone. Hit a foot though, goes in deep. Out comes Earl Hertz. In quick was Wozniak. Couldn't get in as it came over to the far side and stopped by Bosker. Sent over now as Wozniak getting in on it. A little bit of a shove there from Reese. Didn't knock him off his feet though, as that one's in at the side of the net. Trying to wrap around. And a bouncing puck grabbed up by Hertz as bodies are laying down at the side of the net. Hertz gets his gear fixed back up. Gananoque holding a two-goal lead with 11 minutes remaining in the third period, but the Ritos have four-shot advantage with 31 to 27. Will they be able to get another one by Hertz, or is Hertz shut the door? We'll find out here. Smith under it quick. In behind the net. Dixon gets to it first, chips it to the sideboards. Now an opportunity. Here comes Gann, 2-on-2. Weidman, Smith. Smith shot. Grabbed up by Slack as he was not going to let any rebound pop it. Face off to the left of Slack in the Smith Ball zone. 10:45 remaining. One by Gananoque, back to the point onto Latimer's stick. Latimer's shot just wide the net. Comes out the other side, turning quick. Was Smith, couldn't get onto it. Now Salas gonna chase that one down. Trying to get that on his stick, but they just get it by him. As here comes the Ritos coming in, looking, trying to center it. Hit a foot, goes in behind the net as they're gonna chase it down over into the corner. Battle there by the ref, trying to get that puck bouncing. Smith able to chip it by the D. Quick turn back, gets it now. Turned in, shot by Ravit. Couldn't get that one to go by Slack as it comes over to the corner. Here comes Tremblay, gets it forward. As they're trying to get in, Stevens chips it back the other way. As now here's an opportunity, Selick has it coming in with Ravit, tries to center it. Hit the foot, couldn't get that one as it goes off over into the corner. Chipped in, that's gonna be an offside call, stopping the play at 9:49. And that will come outside the Gananoque zone to this close side here by the stands. face off here against Higgs. It's won by Higgs. Back right on. It might have actually been shot in by Pilon. On to Hertz, but it was stopped up now on the Gannockway stick as they're trying to get out of the zone. Sends it up mid-ice. Chip forward. Here comes Higgs. Coming in. Has Blasco with him. Tries to get it, but gets chipped off in behind the net. Some bumping going on there. Out comes the Ritos as Herbert dodged a potential hit from Brown. And a chip in right in front of the net by Salter, comes over to the far board. They can't get that one settled down, but gets chipped back in behind the net, picked up quickly by Gann as they're going to shovel it up to Blasco. Blasco trying to get forward, gets bumped, has to have Duchesne come in and pull that puck out. Duchesne gets it, sends it over to the far side as they're trying to chip it up, but it stays over in the corner, centering to the front of the net. Blasco broke it up, chipped it out. Now here comes Brock Higgs cutting across the center, looking for a shot. And a big save made by Slack goes off over to the corner. Higgs sends it back in behind to Palkowski. Palkowski to Higgs. Higgs tried to get back to the D, but it hit a foot. And the Ritos are able to clear it out. Good stop up there by Duchesne. Bouncing puck. Hand pass. Going to come into the Gannockway zone to the left of Leif Hertz. To 29 on the shots here in the third period, 8:38 remaining. Gannockway leads by two in this game one of the best of five series for the semifinals of the USHL playoffs. Puck chipped out of the zone, down, be chased down by Slack, who gets to it first. Turns it over to Morton. Morton sends over to the far side. So misses everybody, is going to go down as Wiley chased it down, and it's going to be icing. 8:20 remaining. Face-off will be to the left of Dallas Slack. Sparger is going to come in across from Verbeek for this face-off. Face-off won by Verbeek. Back to the point. Shot by Reese Trickler. Couldn't make it through. Onto the stick of Salek. Couldn't get that one to go through either. Has hit a body and now comes it. Reese lays the body out. Here comes Sparger coming through. Centers it across. Shot and a big save made by Hertz. And it's a goal. Through, but enough for a goal, and now the Ritos are only down by one, looking to bring this one back up, tie it up, and send it to extra time or win it in regulation. Sent down in deep. Wozniak tries to get the center back to the point, but can't get it to Keeley as Keeley was outside the zone, sends over the far side. They're going to chip it back in. Latimer going to get to that puck, chip it to the sideboards, goes by, error, gets to the blue. They turn it right back into the corner as onto it is Dixon trying to get it by, but can't get by Swimmington as it comes over the far side. Now Gannockway will bring it out up to center ice, sending it into the slot, trying to make a move here. As Verbeek had that puck poked off his stick, onto it now is Selleck. Selleck's in the corner. Pulling that puck, sends it back to the point. Brown shot it into the side and chipped at the side of the net, but Slack slid over and grabbed it up quickly. 7:12 remaining here in the third period. 31 shots to 29, still on the board. They haven't changed in the last couple shots. Right now, Gannockway holding on to a one-goal lead here at game one. Back to Brown. Brown shot, tried to get it in and a tip, but couldn't get a connection there as it went wide. The net came out their side. Now Brown chips it. Here comes Verbeek, Mangan trying to get through the zone. Couldn't. Coda couldn't get a stick on it either. Comes back to D. Mangan trying to get on it. Takes a hack with the stick, but no official's arms go up. And then you can see Coda came in, gave one of his own. That puck's under the body there. And some digging going on. And he does come out to the neutral zone. Onto the stick of Costello. Costello sends it up ice. And it gets grabbed up by Duchesne. Brown who has it. And he's going to turn it right back in besides slack, but that's going to be icing. Sending it all the way down into Gananoque zone with 6:26 remaining in the third period. Sparger is going to come into the faceoff dot. Faceoff against Coda. Timeout called here. Not sure which team gave the call, but we're going to have a timeout. Gananoque's timeout. And it looks to me, Dixon's not talking with the players, so it looks likely to me is just a time break here to give the players a little bit of a breather and get a break here as that icing keeps them from being able to change. With the one goal lead, that might be a good call right now by Dixon, keeping it with these players fresh, as Hertz has let in three in this third period. And they don't want to let in another one as they're only holding on to this one goal lead. So faceoff will be to the right of Leif Hertz in the Gananoque zone. In comes Coda to face off against Spargu. Spargu wins it back to the point on the Castello stick shot. And they score to tie the game. That one was an awkward shot that went up and over. I don't believe that Hertz saw that one go over, and it just fluttered in to make the game 4-4. And now we got ourselves the game with 6:21 remaining. Higgs gonna come out and take this faceoff against Spargu. One back to the D for Smith Falls as they try to turn it back up. Gananoque's led this entire game until this moment. Well, they did have one little short tie-up, but right now, Gananoque's had the lead and hasn't been down at all yet. Right now, though, Smith Falls looking to try to get their first lead of the game. Here it comes. Blasco in behind the net. Looking, sends it back to the point to Brown. Brown shot, hit a leg. It stayed in the zone, though, as they're going to dig. As you can see, some shoving there as Pilon got a good shot in on Brown, but didn't get a call. We'll see as Dowell now twice in this game. First with Selleck, now with Brown, is going to be getting a target on his back for this series. As you can see, McKinney blew a tire at the blue line, allowing Brown to get that puck. Dealing with the pressure, though, from Salter, and a little bit of a collision is Gananoque having a hard time now in this late third period. Puck stripped from Blasco, sent back in around behind the net as he'll be grabbed up by Latimer, getting some fresh legs on for Gann, as Gann struggling now after losing the lead. Shot coming, tipped, and that one goes up and out of play off of the stick of Samuel Tremblay, and will stay in the zone going to the left of Dallas Slack. So we have 4:56 remaining here in this third period. And everything up to this point doesn't mean much. And the helmet of Slack has come off again. That's the second time this game he's taken it in the head. It looks like, though, he has had some words for Selleck. I think that might have been come off from Selleck and not a shot. Even though I don't believe anybody on Smith Falls is willing to drop the mitts with Selleck, as they've already ran from him once this game. I'm sure if anybody wants to drop the mitts with Selleck, he will gladly take those mitts off and give a person a beating. Verbeek coming in to set up on this faceoff against Bosker. They're battling hard. One in, two. Costello is going to get up to the blue line now. A drive here. Swimmington has to cut back as he has Selleck barreling in on him. Smith Falls sent to the blue line. Now here's an opportunity shot. And the rebound save. They're going to give a little bit of scramble, but he's going to be able to hold on to it. sure why Salek's arguing with the linesman, but something must happen there in that scrum. He had a couple words for him. But they're going to get it back here on to Salek's stick as he's going to drive in over the blue line, tries to center it, but it hits a stick and goes up and out of play and will come to the right of slack in the Smith Falls zone. 4:25 remaining here, 33 shots for Smith Falls, 31 shots for Gananoque. 4-4 is the score in this game one of the semifinals here for the EOSHL. Cobble faces off against Verbeek. Verbeek wins it back to D. They send it back in. Verbeek couldn't get to it, comes back around. As Smith Falls is going to send it down the ice. Chased down here by Graham Brown, picks it up. And he sends it over to the far side. D, as they chip it up and to the neutral ice. Salek chips it over. Couldn't get that one cleanly to Stevens. And now here comes Smith Falls back the other way. They're going to take it in behind the net. Salek looking for a hit, couldn't get it. As they got the shot off before, grabbed up by Hertz. As they'll hold that one with 3:57 remaining in the third period of play. Smith Falls, not accustomed to this. They're not accustomed to it. They played a game that went to overtime last night in Deserano. So these close games in the final minute are not new to them. While the official was talking with the scorekeeper, the linesman dropped the puck, and that's what the whistle was for, as they were not keeping an eye out on their fellow co-workers. Duchesne chops that one to the blue line, gets sent right back in as he'll be chased down by Dowell, who's going to send it over to the far side. Shot from the point, chipped by Higgs, couldn't get to the net as it's still staying into the corner. They're trying to center it, comes back to the point. Keely shot, save made by Hertz, kicked out, and now Gananoque going to drive it down the other way. Stops up his Blasco, he's not alone. Centering it to Palakowski, couldn't get that one in, and Slack made a huge save. Icing is going to be the call. And they're going to be, you see the ref blowing the whistle and pointing back. A couple Smith Falls players tried to sneak on the ice quickly with the icing, but the officials getting them back off and the original players back on the ice. 3:25 remaining, time ticking down in regulation. Next goal could be the winner. That will get sent down, stopped up by Hertz, chipped over to Brown. Brown makes a nice little move to dodge Dowell, and they'll send it down. Dowell going to the bench, gives Gananoque a bit of time. Here comes Higgs, tries to pull it through. Shot, good save by Slack. And the rebound bounced all the way to the blue line. Quick onto it is Brown. He's being chased down, but they were able to turn it back the other way. Now here comes Swimmington. Shot high, save made by Hertz. And a whistle with 2:53 remaining. That came in across from Coda. Coda kicked out for an early move. And they just kicked Mangan out and then dropped the puck before he got 2 feet from the circle. These referees are not doing a good job here tonight. Unfortunately, sad that these two good teams in this good game in the semifinals being ruined by some horrible refereeing. Puck comes out to Smith. Smith carries in over the blue line, sends it in just wide the net. Quick onto it is Mangan. Mangan chips it back in behind to Smith. Smith onto it quick, but tied up with the referee as there was, again, not sure why the referee was getting in the middle of the play behind the net when he didn't need to be, but they're not doing a great job, as we've been mentioning in this game. Now Gananoque gets that puck up to the neutral zone, driving it in. Here comes Mason Mangan into the corner, in behind the net, pinched off by Slack. Still sticking with the puck, got taken off his feet, no call coming, and a shot in, and then a little bit of shoving. Looks like they'll get a bye without too much going on there in front of the net. The amount of calls against Gananoque, you would have thought that trip on Mangan would have been a call, but the referees have picked the team that they're going to stick with this game, and that seems to be the Ritos. So Gananoque is going to do what they can to try to fight to get the W here tonight. In the feet, one over into the corner. Smith Falls trying to get that puck out onto the stick of Verbeek. Verbeek chips it over, gets it to Selick. Selick makes a move. Getting off of the attack, back to the point. Backhand passed in onto Selick's stick, down low. Centering opportunity to Stevens, and he couldn't get that one off. Onto the stick of Duchesne, sent in behind. Verbeek's going to get to it first, send it over here to Brown. Brown backhands it back into Verbeek by everybody. Selick's going to get a chip on it over into the corner. As a pinch there, kept that puck in play. Now to Selick. Selick tries to center back to Brown. Brown shot. What a good block made by Spencer Cobalt. Now a chip out of the zone. As here comes Smith Falls in with numbers, and we're going to have a call coming. Finally, the refs are going to call Smith Falls for something. We'll put that ref on the center camera because that's a good call finally out of him. He does something right and puts in. We've seen multiple GAN players get pulled off their feet this game with nothing coming from the officials. Well, now the officials did call one, and it will put Smith Falls down 2 minutes with a minute 10 remaining in regulation, giving Gananoque a good opportunity here. Back to the point. Over to Duchesne. Shane walks the line, sends it down just wide of the net. Gets out of the zone, goes all the way down. Hertz going to come out to play the puck. Plays it before Spargu could get there. And was picked up by Higgs on the way back now. Sent out of the zone. Here it comes Gananoque. Over to Verbeek in the slot shot. And that one just couldn't get dialed in. As the Ritos send it down the ice. Hertz chips it up to Verbeek, who chips it to Duchesne. Here, Bosco with the puck, leaves it to Verbeek. Verbeek tries to get to Bosco. Bam! So it gets cleared out to Hertz, who's playing the puck more than usual here in this final minute. 10 seconds remaining. Higgs goes in behind his net. It looks like he's just going to kill off the remaining time. As that's going to do it for regulation. So, let's get you caught up on the third period. Smith Falls came out, boom, 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 scored, tied the game up. Gananoque, bam, 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 putting him back up by two. But then, a couple awkward shots in the last one that went in, a fluttering up and over some players, tied this game up at four. And that has put us where we're going into the play or into the overtime. Some things to discuss, though, is that the officiating definitely not doing very well this game. I'm pretty sure both sides aren't too happy. Gananoque, we definitely can't be happy with the amount of players that have been taken off their feet with or without the puck with no call. Finally, though, one was called as it was almost impossible for the ref not to call it as the Gananoque player was taken off both feet off and landed on his back. That got us the penalty to put us where we are now. So Gananoque is coming back on the power play in the third or overtime, maybe 50 seconds of power play time to see if they can't get this one in a win. Smith Falls was here last night, not here in GAN, in Deserano, last night in an overtime game. They were able to win it. We'll see what happens here. Anyone's game here at this point. Will Gananoque take a 1-0 series lead? Will Smith Falls? We're going to find out in the overtime. Thank you for watching. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we got a minute 25 left up on the board as we get ready here for the overtime period of play. There has to be a winner tonight. One team's going to walk away with a victory. One team's going to go home. Right now, Smith Balls, they want to win. They want to keep their momentum going this weekend. They had one win last night in overtime. They want to do it again here tonight. However, Gananoque swept the Tweed Oil Kings, and they want to sweep the Smith Balls Ritos here again. So they have 1 minute before they're going to be coming onto the ice and getting this game going. It's going to be a great overtime. We hope you're excited. Right now, Leaf Hurts and Dallas Slack, both doing a great job. Dallas Slack has 33 saves on 37 shots. No, sorry, 30 saves on 34 shots. Leaf Hurts has 33 saves on 37 shots. So right now we have 71 shots so far in this game. And we have 8 goals across the board. It's going to be a 5-4 victory. Someone's walking away. Who will it be? The music's starting. The players are going to be coming. It's game time. Don't give the music and a buzzer to get the refs out of the room. They're coming out now. Remaining on the penalty, number 25, Griffin Patterson for tripping. And here comes Leif Hurts. One back to the D of Gananoque as they look to get that puck out. They do a little D-D pass, looking for some space. Curls back is Duchesne, who'll send it back over to Verbeek now. Chipped out of the zone to the far side. Onto Higgs's stick. Higgs coming in. Gananoque looks to be rolling with 1D and 4 forwards right now. As Hurts is going to stop that up behind his net, leaving it there for Duchesne. Duchesne plays it up to Brock Higgs, who's going to send it over to the far side. Now Verbeek coming in, stops up, centers it across, trying to hit Selick. Selick grabs that puck up, back in behind the net, chips it out to Verbeek, but just out of the reach, as now here comes Smith Falls. 2-on-2. Nothing. Series lead here and upset Gananoque in the the first game of round three, the semifinals, or if you want to call it the Western Conference Finals. Right now, Smith Falls leading at 1-0. You hear fans going nuts in this building right now, as what a victory that was. Gananoque chose to do a 4-1 setup, four forwards, one D. Did it cost them? We don't know. We know they did. Lost the game. Was it due to that, or was it just a great play by Smith Falls? Either way, going in to game two, Smith Falls is going to have the victory. I'm not with you for game three. Game three, I'm covering the U22 Elite. Kingston Juniors, their home game against the Blue Water Hawks. So I will not be available for game three. I do believe it will be streamed for you guys from another provider, so keep an eye out for that. But if it gets to game five, I'll see you guys then. Hope you enjoyed the game. We hope you enjoyed the stream. And please, check us out next time. Thanks for watching.